First piece was by Alfred Reed, and he describes it himself as just one canticle of praise and using the band as a choir. And I think you can hear that. So we thought it was a fitting selection right here at the end of Holy Week and all the celebrations from the last week to play that as our concert opener. It's a big piece. Good job, guys. Thank you. We're moving on to something completely opposite of that, The Seal Lullaby by Eric Whitaker. There's a book called The White Seal by Rudyard Kipling. And in the beginning of that book, he tells the story of a seal that sings a lullaby to her cub. And the poem that he writes inspired Eric Whitaker to write this piece. So enjoy The Seal Lullaby.
Thank you.
going to say, and I recognized him at the end of that piece. The great thing about teaching music at a university is there's always great musicians floating around, and we're so lucky to have Rob Arneson as a pianist here in town, who does a lot of playing for our students, and he's just great. He's a great person to have around, and always says yes when we need someone to play for our ensemble. So I just wanted to say again to Rob, thank you very much for doing this. He wrote this huge symphony for band and then extracted from it something smaller. So this is that extraction, that smaller sort of sampling of what that symphony is. His symphony is called Wine Dark Sea, which is it's a line from the Odyssey, how Homer describes the sea as Odysseus is traveling home after they've delivered the Trojan horse. And this particular part of that symphony is kind of the journey home. All of the things, you know, they think, oh, it's over, we're done, we have all these trophies of war, and then there's all these new crazy trials and tribulations that he has to face along the way home. So this piece embodies that. So this is Until the Scars. When this piece is finished, we're going to have a little bit of a personnel change for some students from the wind ensemble who are going to be joining us. So be patient as we do some circulating of members. Thank you very much. Until the Scars.
Thank you. 7:30 Friday, this this room if you would like to come, if you enjoy what you're about to hear. So anyway, I've been asking the question lately, how are you feeling? Yes, a lot of the music I write ponders this question for myself. What am I feeling? How do I communicate it? How do I respond? These are the very same questions that arose as I began writing this piece. It's important, I think, to ask ourselves, how do we respond to events in our lives? Passing a class, failing an audition, losing a loved one, or finding another. The way we respond to these events is integral to the human experience, and this is a collection of mine. I hope that you can hear them in our piece, in my piece, in our piece, response.
last Tuesday, just a week ago tonight, for our orchestra concert, you heard me explain that for the first time with our groups here, we've sort of attacked a piece with both an orchestral version and a version for band alone. So last week you heard the version of Turina's La Procession di Rocchio with strings, you know, all the string complement and all the winds. Filled up the room, there were a lot of people in here. And then tonight you hear the arrangement by Alfred Reed, who coincidentally wrote the first piece on the program that you heard tonight, Alleluia, La Domeste. Reed has a pretty broad catalog of music for band, especially for band. And this is part of his sort of transcription catalog. In the mid-20th century, when we had nothing else to play because we didn't have any original music, people were transcribing orchestral music for bands. And this is one of those. If you've ever been to Spain, or anywhere really in South America, you know that there are a lot of really big Marian festivals, like Mary, affiliated with the church, Marian festivals. And this is this piece is based on that same sort of thing. In June in Seville, there's this huge Marian festival, and the opening movement sort of is the town gathering at the square. You can imagine all these families building these ridiculously over-the-top floats, right? Lots of money spent on them. They built them in the big giant parade in the center of town. And then the second half of the piece is the procession. And the procession ends, of course, with a very solemn ceremony. And the piece ends very calm and soft, and then like, boom, loud, smacks you in the face. So if you're following along in the program and you're like, oh God, I know I'm not supposed to clap between movements because people yell at you for that, I don't know why, but it's a thing. This piece goes right from one movement to another. So when it's over, it's really over. You don't have to wait for us to play the second movement. It's a party. We don't stop. It just keeps going all the way through. So we hope you enjoy Joaquin Turina's La Procession di Rocchio as arranged by Alfred Reed.
Thank you.
Dennis Johnson, Mr. John Fannin, both Director Emeritus of the band program with us tonight. I wanted to say one more note about the composition thing. A minute ago, we heard Mick's piece, which is terrific, right? We have a really wonderful history here of performing music by composers that live here, right? So Mr. Fannin has written several works for concert band that were played by both either the symphonic band or various honor groups around here, so that's been great. And our colleague, Dr. D'Ambrosio, who's also on the balcony, has written a piece that Mr. Johnson premiered with the Wind Ensemble titled Racer One, and is now published. Too, which Sea Island Publications is really great. So there's a long history of performing original music and new music here at Murray State, so we're really happy to be continuing that tradition. The last group of people I want to recognize tonight are our seniors. These are students that are either graduating in just a couple of weeks. I know we're all panicked. It's just a couple of weeks. But in any case, or they're student teaching in the fall. They might be a music ed major who's student teaching in the fall. So I want to recognize all of them and have them stand, and then I'll ask you to hold your applause to the end and thank them all at the end for all the work that they put in over the last 3, 4, or 5 years that they've been with us. It's really been a remarkable experience to work with all of them. So I'll just, in the order of that I have you on the list, Mick Hawkins, or Mick is a senior double major in music education and composition. Joey Reynolds on tenor saxophone, majoring in television production. Noah Wright, euphonium music major and euphonium performance. Corey Brewer on trombone, music performance major on trombone. Ryan Haygood, Ryan is a senior music ed major, student teaching in the fall. Zach Boardman, where are you? Oh, you're here, you played well, yeah. Zach is a senior music business student. Nick Fuson, where are you, Nick? Nick is a senior music ed major as well, student teaching in the fall. Micah Kraus is a senior music performance major in tuba performance. And Tyler Wright, where's Tyler? Tyler Wright is a senior music business major. These are all students playing the last concert with us tonight. If you could help us thank them for all the work they've done. Rotating through playing with that concert. So they played one piece in the concert tonight, plus Nick's piece, plus this combined piece, so three pieces. But last week they played three other pieces, and so they've just been torn in a million different pieces of places as well. So if you play a recital, a junior or senior recital this month, plus or minus 30 days, would you stand? What? Okay. If you are playing on a music or have played on a music composition recital for another student, please stand. Great. If you are playing in a your studio's choir / ensemble / cohort of members from your studio, please stand. So you see, we have almost everybody up here who's played 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 concerts in the last 30 days. So they're welcoming a few days off in the next few days. So thank you all for your time and all the effort you put in.
Combined wind ensemble and symphonic band. When we planned this, we thought we would be in a much larger space than this, so we do apologize for the size of the ensemble. Thank you for hanging with us. We know it gets warm in this room. We really appreciate you being here. It means a lot when we get to share back the work that we do with people who love music. So These are the best audiences, and actually this is kind of nice. We're close, we don't have a big space separating us. This is like immersion band. So we welcome you here. We thank you very much. This last piece, With Heart and Voice, it's a big band piece written by David Gillingham, who scores music beautifully for the wind ensemble. He's a percussionist himself, so he's really great at writing a lot of interesting percussion parts, sometimes mirroring those in the woodwinds, not so interestingly, but he writes really great music for band, and when we talked about, we did a combined piece back in February, it went really well, and we thought we would try it again, and we were looking for something that involved all the members of the ensemble at a really high level, and this is the piece that we chose, and it's based on an alma mater for a high school. It was actually commissioned by a high school that wanted something based on their alma mater. But if you listen really closely, I think you'll recognize the tune of the alma mater is actually a hymn tune, Come Christians Join to Sing. So you'll recognize that, and believe me, it's a bit of an earworm, so you'll be humming it when you leave the room tonight. But it's very beautiful. There's dark moments, there's hope, there's light moments in this piece. We hope you enjoy, and this will be our last piece tonight with